Hey everyone, it's MonaAlicia on YouTube. Happy spring! By the time that you see this, it will probably be a week from today, but I am recording this on the very first day of spring. As you can see, my lovely new floral print dress is out and ready to rock. So, in honor of the first day of spring, this video is about spirit animals. And this is a video about how to find your spirit animal. So if you were ever curious, I've got a couple of helpful tips for you in case you ever wanted to explore what your spirit animal spirit guide possibly is. So let's begin. Okay, so you have your question, what's my spirit animal? I'm going to tell you a little story that a couple years ago I went on vacation with my friend, and we were up in Maine, and she was telling me how she experienced, she had a couple of questions for herself at that time. We were going to an art school that had just shut down, and she was debating on whether or not choosing this art school that I was going to or another one. So the question was, which one do I choose? And she said that when she was thinking about the other school that she did end up going to, she saw her spirit animal, which was a blue heron, fly across the highway, and she knew that that was the right choice for her. So I'm talking to her about this, and I am curious, and I kept telling her the entire time that I was on my trip with her, I want to know what my spirit animal is. So lo and behold, she was actually the one who kind of pointed out my first totem animal, and I will get to totem animals in just a second. So while we were on vacation and we were up hiking near a waterfall, she said that she kept on seeing a yellow swallowtail butterfly hovering around me. And I thought that was really neat. So every time that I have a general question, I kind of put it out there to the universe and wait to see. I might not actually see a live butterfly, but I might see a symbol of a butterfly somewhere. And every time I see a symbol of a butterfly, it's gonna be a good day. So that's how I take that. So there are a couple of ways that you can do this. One is you can just generally ask the universe out loud. You can say, universe, show me what my spirit animal is. Open your heart, open your mind to this possibility. Go about your day, you know, go grocery shopping, go pick up your laundry, etc. You know, go about your business. Now, it might seem as if you forgot about it. Now, if an animal comes to you, and it doesn't have to be a live animal, it can be a representation of an animal or a symbol of an animal, a painting, a drawing, a depiction, yada, yada, yada. If you see that animal that sticks out to you in some way, shape, or form, like, oh, there's a raccoon on the ground, or there's a raccoon in the park, there's a squirrel in a tree, there's a bluebird that just flew across my path, that could be the answer that you're looking for. Now, keep that in mind as you go about your day, and keep asking yourself kind of like general questions. Is today going to be a good day? Something like that. And if you see your animal pop up more than once, then that's going to be a good day, and that's probably your animal. Now, you can feel free to go home and look up what that animal means. When I looked up butterfly, butterflies are a symbol of joy, and so around that time, I think I really needed that symbol in my life. I needed to be happy. And not to say that I'm not a happy person already, but, you know, it's just, it's a nice light feeling to get that reminder. So that is one way that you can look up your spirit animal or ask the universe what your spirit animal is. Now, another thing that you can do is pay attention to your surroundings. Say something good happens to you, look around to see if there are any multiples of any types of animal symbolism anywhere. And, you know, it's like, again, it doesn't have to be a live animal. It could be a sticker on somebody's car, etc. You could be walking through a bookstore and then you'll see a fox on a children's book cover and it pops out to you. For instance, you know, again, it also is very cool because it depends, you know, different animals mean different things. So whatever is going on in your life right now, that is a message from the universe trying to tell you something. Now, you can also have multiple spirit animal totems, and we call that a totem. So that is what you see in American Indian culture. You see like the totems with the animal heads. So that is what I mean. For me, my first totem, and I consider this my first animal totem, was the butterfly. After that, for a little bit, I thought that the dog was in my life for a little bit trying to tell me something. I also have the whale as a spirit animal, and right now the robin, and robins are a symbol of spring. So it's important to know that you can have multiple spirit animals that mean different things, and also different animals mean different things, like I said before. So, for instance, a butterfly is joy, a dog is loyalty, a wolf is communication, and a whale is creativity and rebirth, and robins are also a symbol of new beginnings. Like, for instance, when it comes to the robin, last week I was working on a new art project, and while I was working on a new art project, all of these robins showed up in front of my window and sat themselves in the tree, and there were a lot of them. Alright, I took a video of it. It was really awesome. So I thought to myself, okay, this is good. We're good. We're doing something really good here, which is what I like to see. It's progress for myself, and as an artist, I struggle with that. So it's always good to know that it's always good to know that animals do mean different things. You know, if you're into it, definitely do your research. I've also had dreams. If you have dreams of a recurring animal, that could be an animal trying to tell you something. Whales come up in my dream a lot, and when they are in my dream, it's almost always very terrifying. Either I'm being dragged into the water by it, I'm being swallowed by it, I'm in a container or a containment chamber with a whale, which is very terrifying because they are very massive creatures. So it's always interesting because when I am in my dream, very scary. But if I'm out in public during the daytime and I see a picture of a whale, that means it's good for me. Okay? It's funny because in the daytime and in real life, when I'm out going about my business and I see a whale, it's fine, but in my dreams it's like a nightmare. So it's really funny. So if you ever have recurring dreams of an animal, chances are that is one of your spirit totems. And another thing to keep in mind is when you do research your animal, does the symbolism resonate with you? For instance, if you're having constant dreams of whales coming up behind you as you're trying to swim and pulling on your feet to pull you into the water, and because a whale symbolizes creativity, I took that as, girl, you need to work on your art. You have put it off for too long. You need to get back into that. And so I started doing that, and I haven't had a whale dream since. So pay attention for that. Another option that you have to discover your spirit animal is that if you ever had a fascination with a certain animal since you were young, that could be it. That could be your animal. For instance, for me, horses are my absolute favorite animal ever since I was a little girl. I have no idea why. I didn't meet a horse until I was at least in elementary school, but I finally did get to meet a horse, and I just love the way that they look. I think they're powerful, they're beautiful, they're majestic, very cute animals. You know, another option or another animal that I think is kind of prominent for me is the cat, which is funny because I'm allergic to cats and I don't find myself being a cat person, but I actually have a couple of stuffed animals and I have a little cat symbol. Like, I like Pusheen, I like Hello Kitty. I've got one of those little, I think they're little Japanese Korean like squishy cat things. It's like a little beanbag. Anyway, so that's another thing. And cats stand for mystery and witchcraft. You know, I'll take it. I'm not allergic to the symbol, so those are just some fun little things that you can do to help discover what your spirit animal is. And it's just a fun little exercise, you know. Ask the universe, you know, what's my spirit animal? You know, really think about it. You know, is there an animal that you really like? Is there an animal that pops up into your life a lot when something good happens? Maybe you have dreams about them. And you know what? It's all fascinating it's all good, and I hope that you continue to have a great rest of the week. Happy spring. Enjoy the day. Enjoy the sunshine. Enjoy the warmth that's going to be coming into our lives more. And I hope you enjoy. Have a blessed day. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.